بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن شاء الله I would be given a تجويد course which will include مخارج انصفات الحروف. مخارج means articulation points of the Arabic letters. صفات means characteristics of the Arabic letters. Now this lesson is very important to attend because this is the foundation of the Quran. If you don't know where to place the tongue, if you don't know if the letter comes out from the throat, from the tongue, from the lips, then you're going to have, you know, a problem with saying the correct letter. So I found that from experience that this is the base of the Quran, knowing the Arabic letters and where they articulate from and what is the sifa of these letters. Because some letters, they share the same makhraj. For example, the dal and the ta and the ta, they share the same makhraj, same articulation point. What makes a difference is the sifat. Sifat is the characteristics. So for example, when you say at, so the ta has air, hams in it, it means air. When you say ad, the dal does not have that hams in it, that air. So if we don't, if we apply or if we add hams to the ta, if we apply hams to the dal, then the dal becomes like a ta. So when you say yawmiddin, yawmiddin, is that a dal or ta? Right? So because I added hams to the dal, it becomes yawmiddin, the day of figs. So you need to get rid of the hams, the air, for it to be strong. Yawmiddin versus yawmiddin, yawmiddin versus yawmiddin. I'm repeating so you can hear the difference. And it does change the meaning. So it's very important to know where to place the tongue and what kind of sifa should I apply to this letter. How do I know? That's what this course is all about. So I've been teaching Quran for over 20 years, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. And from experience, from teaching so many people from different countries, I found that this lesson is very important. The makharij and sifat al-huruf, that, you know, for people to know where should I place my tongue in order to get a good letter, right? So inshallah ta'ala, I will try to make these videos very short. And so they're available for anyone that, you know, you have little time to give some of your time to study some of the letters daily. Inshallah, I'll try to go very easy, inshallah, one letter or two letters at a time, or maybe one makhraj at a time. Okay, and then after that, I will talk about sifat, and I'll give many, many examples. Inshallah, I will try to give the common mistakes that people do. Again, from my own experience teaching, I know so many mistakes that people, you know, common mistakes that people do. That it doesn't mean that this mistake is done by everybody. No, some people do this mistake, some people do another type of mistakes. But I'll try to cover as much as I can mistakes and how to fix it so you can avoid it, how to practice. Inshallah ta'ala, this would be, you know, this will help you a lot. So if you have any question, any comment, any, you know, suggestions, anything, you can write it in the comment, inshallah, on the bottom. So for now, I will, you know, I will end with this. And next video would have pictures in it, so which would make it easier, inshallah ta'ala. And I will show you everything where each letter comes out from. May Allah accept it from us, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it sincere. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.